So hi folks, and welcome to Winners in the Cloud, our tech series dedicated to Winners 365 for IT pros like yourself. So please make sure to register for the Winners IT Pro YouTube channel to stay up to date about the latest news around Winners 365. You can find it in the link below here. So I'm very excited to introduce our next guest from Customer Lego. So our first customer story at Winners in the Cloud. So Philip, how are you doing?
I'm doing fine, thanks. How are you?
I'm doing great too. A little bit of a time difference here. You're in Denmark and I'm in the Redmond area. But we figured it out, right? So with technology, we can just make it work. So before we get started and talk a little bit more about your experiences and such, can you tell the viewers a little bit more about yourself and where you're at right now?
Yeah. At the moment, I'm at Billund, our headquarters in Denmark. But a little about myself, I'm a lead engineer for what we call colleague devices in the Lego group. And that is supporting all our colleagues with hardware. And that entails both Windows machines, but also smartphones and a little bit of Apple products also. So, we are trying to take it all for our colleagues.
Yeah, that's great to hear. And I remember you use as well like solutions like Microsoft Endpoint Manager and such before using Winners 365, right?
Yeah, correct. We are actually at the moment in a hybrid scenario. So we're using SCCM and moving towards Intune as our primary tool of management.
Oh, yeah, that's great. But before we jump into like more of the specifics here, Lego has been very important for a lot of like IT pros as well during the pandemic. And I personally myself, I've been building a couple of them as well, just for fun and relax and break the time a little bit as well. So one thing I would like to challenge the audience as well that listens to this episode, like if you hear this and you think, hey, I did that as well, feel free to post some creations here in the chat. We would love, and I guess Philip would love to see them as well.
That would be very awesome.
Exactly. So if you have some examples, Philip, perhaps of your creations you see as part of Lego that people have sent over or have been catched on social media, we maybe can perhaps share that in this episode as well. So
I can definitely share some of the creations here at campus. There are both small creations, but also very large creations. So I think that would be fun for people to see.
Yeah, we will throw them in here while we are chatting about this. So so you said you're like Lego Billund. I'm pretty sure you're not playing mini golf and everything there. So you're really working hard in building the operations, the future of the operations and the environments that enable different scenarios in your organization. So I really would like to, before we jump into what you're building today with Winners 365 and be part of the digital transformation of hybrid remote work and Windows and Windows 11, perhaps too. I remember us connecting three years ago around Azure or Windows Virtual Desktop back then, now Azure Virtual Desktop. And that's not the solution we are talking about right now. So can you tell us a little bit of like what changed in the last 3 years? What are the kind of decisions that you guys have been made and where you're at right now? So
yes, well, like many other companies, you know, the digital transformation is also very key in the Lego group. And actually, one of our biggest things at the moment are we are onboarding a lot of digital employees, meaning developers and other, you know, user types and colleagues than we normally did before. So we are still a big production company, but we're also beginning to become a big digital company. So in that regard, we of course need to develop our infrastructure towards a cloud setting, just, you know, for the digital purpose of being more agile and also being able to move faster with the development in all different ways. So we have begun a cloud-only journey within the Lego group and also, you know, just taking in a lot of different consultants and employees to support us, both towards the customer, but also internally towards building the right products within the Lego group.
Yeah, that's great to hear. And how important has it been to consolidate, for example, that Microsoft Endpoint Manager environment with as well the Cloud PC virtual environment in your scenario? Has it been one of the reasons to move to Windows 365 as well?
Yeah, one of our mantras is actually reduce technical debt. And the way to do that is actually to mobilize our infrastructure towards not only, you know, one platform, but a platform that supports all different kind of user needs. So, you know, when a consultant gets onboarded in the Lego group, we wish to give them the best possible way to work together with the employees who are regular employees in the Lego group. And one of the ways we see that is actually our Windows 365 platform to support, you know, an agile way of working and also a very fast cloud-enabled way of working.
Yeah, so how important has, like, bring your own device be for this infrastructure as well? You say about, like contractors, freelancers, the easiness of deploying the environment, but it's like flexibility in terms of usage for the endpoint device as well, very important for you?
It is important, but actually we don't support a bring your own device per se. If you want to have a true Lego experience, you will get a device from the Lego group. That's the way we see the most fit for the Lego group and the security posture we want. So, but we definitely see a value about our consultants not having to buy a special tool or a special OS or something. They can just use a virtual desktop anywhere. And I also actually saw a pretty funny segment that you shared. I can't remember when, but when you run up a Windows 365 in a Tesla, I think that's an awesome way of showing how agile this product is.
Yeah, it definitely is. It makes work from anywhere sort of possible from within a car as well, potentially. So how important has been like teams in Windows 365 for the organization? Can you share a little bit about that?
Yeah, actually, you know, COVID, everyone knows that teams became a mainstay in a lot of Danish companies, at least. So, you know, we actually also wanted a solution that really supported the native Teams experience you have on a physical hardware device. So that's actually also one of the things that Microsoft highlighted in an early way that, you know, Windows 365 is at the moment playing a little catch-up, but I know that you just deployed blurry backgrounds and also, so that's really big value because when we look at value in the products that we want to introduce to our colleagues, we look very much at the colleague value. So what's their response to the product that we deliver for our colleagues?
Yeah, it's great to hear. And it's just great to see that the customers are like heavily adopting and appreciating as well Microsoft Teams on top of a Cloud PC environment because, yeah, just like you use Teams on a physical PC, it should work as well, just the same as on a Cloud PC environment. So, and that's great to hear. And so I heard that you use as well Azure AD Join, the new supported domain join configuration as part of Windows 365. So can you share a little bit about that and how that onboarding process has been much easier than using hybrid, for example?
Yes, well, you know, it just fits real well because we actually embarked on an autopilot project simultaneously. So we're actually moving all our endpoints or Windows machines to AD also. So we can just fit all the policies that we're doing in that regard to also support our Windows 365. We can use the same groups and we don't have to, you know, look into, okay, what are we doing over here and what are we doing over here? So it just makes our engineering capability a lot easier, and we can also do a lot more automation in that regard. So that was a big part of that. And so then, of course, being cloud-only is a big value statement in that regard.
That's great. And we hear it from more customers as well, that since Azure AD joined, the onboarding process is really like as easy as a SaaS solution should be. So that's great to hear from you guys as well. So what I heard as well is that you guys started with a smaller POC and then expanded to more users. Can you share a little bit about that approach of starting smaller and scaling to a larger amount?
Yes, actually, you know, I touched on it shortly just before, but user value or colleague value is a big thing, and we actually want to ensure when we try to deploy something new, we get feedback that is valuable for us, but also valuable for the user. So we try to, every time we introduce something new, we try to do a proof of concept. So in this regard, we actually took, I think we bought 200 licenses to start with, and then we just launched them to different user types using a virtual desktop before. And the feedback that we got was that it was a lot quicker to spin up. You know, they loved the more teams or the native teams experience, and just having the ability to have your camera turned on when being on a virtual desktop. So you know, the value we got actually, you know, just persuaded us that this was the right way to go. And then it just, as I mentioned before, really fit in the architecture that we want to go with moving forward.
Yeah, that's awesome to hear. And with that, I think we can maybe switch to the more like IT pro audience specific kind of questions. Like, what are your lessons learned? Like, did you... Yeah, had some things to overcome, like network issues and such. And what do you recommend to the audience to do when they are going into a POC and eventually production as well?
Yeah. One of the biggest values in the Windows 365, as we see just from, you know, speed of deployment and performance, is the possibility to run up in local data centers. You also had that in other virtual desktop solutions, but in this, it was quite easy to do within our environment already. But we saw some issues about, you know, not getting the connection being unstable. So if we just had decided to go with this and buy all the licenses we needed without doing the proof of concept with the end users and seeing how this worked in real life from a global standpoint, then we wouldn't have had those learnings. So we had to use, I think, 6 weeks to just find the errors within our network client or VPN client and then mitigate those. And then when we did that, we were actually in a really good place and we see that performance that we wanted when we mitigated that.
Yeah, that's great to hear. And I think a great takeaway for the audience here to make sure that your network is like able to reach the URLs that are needed to use Microsoft Endpoint Manager and Windows 365. Because you're going to SaaS and cloud services, it's more and more important to optimize your network instead of your own infrastructure because you move to a managed service offering, just like Windows 365 is. So one thing I think is funny because I see people walking down the hall behind you. So you actually are at the Lego headquarters there. And like all the IT pros here, they probably want to learn a little bit about like Lego as well, right? So can you share a little bit maybe some of the new creations that are coming up or some pictures that you can share so people know, hey, after this episode, I'm probably going to build this new creation for my back wall, my Teams calls or something like that?
I can definitely share some, you know, creations, you know, they are often, you know, I get them notified like anyone else because, you know, there's a lot of secrecy about new creations. But you know, we are, of course, doing a new thing, actually, that is LegoCon, and that's rolling out mid-June next week. I'll share a link you can share with your viewers. So I think that's really awesome. And then, of course, I can also share some pictures about Canvas. And I think one of the biggest things about Canvas, and maybe if you're employed at, you know, some of the big techs in the U.S., it's not that, you know, crazy. But in Denmark, it's crazy. We have something called People House, where you and your spouse actually can use Lego facilities. So, you know, there's a bar, there's a hotel, there's at the end, you know, you can knitting and all kinds of creative stuff, and of course a lot of Lego bricks. So you can just take your family, and the Lego house is actually open from, I think, 7 o'clock in the morning to 12 o'clock in the evening. So you have a lot of also free time where you can that you can use at the Lego campus here in Finland. So I think that's very, you know, awesome just to take in the families. And we also have the Legonista. That's the pensioners of Lego. They also have access throughout their life. So we really are in a way a company that really goes above and beyond. So I think that's truly awesome. Truly awesome.
Yeah, that's great to hear that adults can create excuses for their kids to come as well, so they can have some fun too. I still remember I presented my first large presentation at Legoland in Billund, and I remember the organization put me in a fairy tale room there with some disco lights as part of the shower. So I have a special moment to Legoland in Billund. So it's just amazing over there. So before we wrap up, really thank you for everything you just shared. But how can people stay in touch with you if they want to connect or just follow you on social media or something like that?
Yeah, I have my LinkedIn profile. I think you shared that in your latest post, and you're very welcome to connect with me there. I'm always ready for connecting. You know, I'll try to share some technology things, but maybe it will be Lego related because, you know, I'm also very much, you know, a play kid, and it's actually quite expensive for me to work at Lego because we have our employee shop down the first floor, and, you know, you go by that sometimes.
Just like we have the Microsoft store at campus, you have the Lego store, and I know how hard it can be to avoid that store, to don't just walk in after working day and purchase something accidentally.
So the latest version was definitely the Back to the Future car. I needed to have that, so you know.
Well, that's awesome. I'm probably buying that one myself too. So we will post your link to your LinkedIn page here in the link down below. And with that, I would like to really thank you, Philip, for being our first customer story guest on the Winners in the Cloud podcast. And I would like to thank the audience as well for listening in and be consistent in watching our episodes. And if you are a new listener, a new audience member, please go to ak.ms/winners-in-the-cloud to watch our other episodes as well. Or just follow me on my social channel, @brinkof_c as well. So thank you for watching, and hopefully we see you at the next episode. So thank you.